And we're back for part three. Glue. Alright, so. Set this out of the way. As you can probably, I don't know if you can tell in the video, but my shop is tiny. It's just a garage. But, you know, I started out in a 8x12 storage building. When I moved here to Missouri, it was tight. There was no room to work. But I still built projects. I still had fun. And then was fortunate enough. Wow, caught that on video. It was great. Cluttered mess in here. Now you know, it's not good. That's a tiny bike. It folds up. All right, here we go. Quarter inch. See how much of a mess it is when you're being here carrying shit around by yourself. All right. I'm gonna set one of these sideboards under here to hold her up. Figure out how long it needs to be. I guess I can show that too. So, our dado is a quarter deep. And here we have 53 inches exactly. So we need our bottom piece to be 53 and a half by 18 and 7/8. 53 and a half is my length. We got our 53 and a half, I reckon. I hope that's right. Yep. 53 and a half. That's what I'm getting. T-square from above you guys over there. And tape measure. And a pencil. 53 and a half, is that what I said? Yeah. Alright. So I'm gonna mark it here. Double check that my square's square. What I'd love to do is to have a clamping straight edge. Oh, I do have a clamping straight edge. I do. I don't think it's gotta be that critical. I'm gonna rip it with a skill saw by hand. Square can go back up here. Yeah, we're gonna rip it by hand. Since I'm on top of the table saw, that my blade's not set too deep. That's very important because I'd hate to dull my new blade. The saw has a mark on it, it says quarter inch, so I'll just go with that. Double check it, make sure it's deep enough. Plenty, plenty, plenty. And we're gonna cut. Because who wouldn't want to? Love the table saw. All right. I think I said 18 and 7/8. Should have been 19, but you know. No, we'll try it. We'll go with 19. Be a tight fit. This stuff's been sitting in here conditioning and drying for long enough that should have no trouble. 19, just under, just a hair under. Raise the blade. Turn it on and we'll cut. Hard on the side of it when you're cutting, if you don't push that way, you should just freehand it, let it float forward through the table saw. And it, I mean, it's great. It just works great. I love it. Why? All right, here's this. That's a pretty piece of wood. Maybe birch or cabinet bottom. Well,
back up 7 minutes. I'm gonna go to